At this moment, I mean, currently the European Union is actually helping the wrong guys. Right? So, I mean, from this carrot and the stick policy, you can see only carrots, a lot of carrots for the wrong guys. In terms of democratic progress, we really can see the deterioration. Mm-hmm. I mean, worsening of condition. If you take, for example, democracy score of that was produced annually by Freedom House's publication Nations in Transit, you can see very clearly for all these five countries that it's going down. Yeah, so democratic process is going down. We see more and more authoritarian tendencies. Democratic institutions are violated all over the place. And it is an interesting thing because I think one of the reasons why this is happening is because of the very superficial and very shallow European integration process, which applies to all these countries. So all these countries are candidates for the membership in European Union. But because the process is so superficial and so shallow and looks only at the form, we see that the outcome of this process in terms of democratic development and economic development too, is actually the opposite of what it should be. So the European integration process used to be kind of a boost in the 90s for all these countries which were transforming themselves and going towards European Union. Now it seems to be the opposite. I mean,
but you said that
the European Union is helping the country, right? But it's actually helping the political elite, which is currently in the office. You know, of course, this political elite is elected, but in a process which is democratically very questionable. When the state is signing a contract with some private investor or some private professional management of some other company, such contracts should be public, should be publicized, should be, I mean, everybody should see them. But let me give an example of Smederevo Steel Factory from 2015. No. The Smederevo Steel Factory has been in troubles for decades, right? And then the Prime Minister announced a professional management in 2015, which will bring this company finally up from their knees and launch them into economic market of the Europe, and which will transform the region and Serbia and everybody else. So it was announced as a kind of extremely good solution. Mm-hmm. The professional management came to the company, 12 people who were paid extremely good money. Right? 1 year on, the steel factory declares a loss in the amount of 144 million euros. The company is now has to pay this debt, which will basically be paid by the citizens of Serbia. Right? The management is gone. Nobody is guilty. And that contract, which was made between the government of Serbia and this professional management, was secret. And nobody blinks an eye when this was, some things which would never be done in European Union, which European official would never support in their home countries, they are just pretending not to see in Serbia and some other countries.